मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज कॉन्सेप्ट इज माइनर कोफैक्टर एंड एडजॉइंट ऑफ ए स्क्वेयर मैट्रिक्स। वी नो द डेफिनेशन ऑफ स्क्वेयर मैट्रिक्स। ए मैट्रिक्स इन विच नंबर ऑफ रोस इज इक्वल टू नंबर ऑफ कॉलम्स, वी कॉल्ड दैट मैट्रिक्स एज द स्क्वेयर मैट्रिक्स। नाउ सी द डेफिनेशन ऑफ द माइनर ऑफ ए स्क्वेयर मैट्रिक्स। लेट ए बी एनी स्क्वेयर मैट्रिक्स then minor of any element aij, aij means is a general element of the given square matrix, is obtained by deleting corresponding row and column of the determinant A, where Aij belongs. Okay, then that determinant value is called the minor of the particular element. Okay. For example, see, I am taking one square matrix 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Suppose here see A11, A12, A21, A22. Okay. Aij means that represents general element. Suppose A22, I value is 2, J value is 2. A21, I value is equal to 2, J value is equal to 1. Okay. Suppose if you want to find the minor of the A11, that means element 1, first you need to write the determinant A. Determinant A is equal to determinant 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Now see, you need to find the minor of the element 1. Minor of any element of the square matrix is obtained by deleting the corresponding row and column of the determinant A where that element belongs. See, your element belongs to the first row and the first column, right? Delete the first column and first row. Then see, you will get determinant 4, right? Therefore, minor of the element 1 is equal to 4. Suppose if you want to calculate minor of 4, okay? See, in this matrix, I am taking determinant 1, 2, 3, 4. Then minor of 4 is equal to, it is obtained by, see, deleting the corresponding row and column, because your element 4 is in R2 and C2. To get the minor, you need to cancel the corresponding row and corresponding column. Then remaining element is 1. Minor of 4 is equal to 1. This is how to calculate minor of a square matrix of order 2. Now consider a square matrix of order 3. A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 1, 1, 2, 0, 1, 2. Okay. You need to calculate minor of the all the elements. So, first I am taking determinant A. It is equal to determinant 1, 2, 3, 1, 1, 2, 0, 1, 2. Okay. Now see, minor of 1, this element 1 is equal to, minor of 1 is equal to, you need to delete the first row and the first column. What you will get? Determinant 1, 2, 1, 2. Then calculate the determinant value into 1 is 2, minus 2, it's equal to 0. Therefore, minor of this 1 is equal to 0. Then minor of 2 is equal to, delete the first row and the second column. Okay. So, here you will get determinant 1, 2, 0, 2. Calculate the determinant value. 2 into 1 is 2. 2 into 0 is 0. Its value is equal to 2. Then, minor of the element 3. It is obtained by deleting the third column and the first row, right? Third column and first row you will get a determinant 1101. Calculate the determinant value. Product of diagonal entry is 1 minus product of non-diagonal entry is 0. 1 minus 0 is equal to 1. Okay. Now see, in the next step, you need to calculate the minor of the element. Next element is here 1 minor of this 1 is equal to. Now see, your element is in the second row and the first column, right? So delete the second row and the first column. Then what you will get? Determinant 2, 3 and here 1, 2. Okay, you will get. Calculate the determinant value. 2 to the 4 minus 3, its value equal to 1. Okay, next see minor of 1. Okay, minor of, again one more entry 1 is there. This is obtained by deleting the second row and the second column. Then see, you will get a determinant 1, 3, 0, 2. 2 into 1 is 2. 3 minus 0 is 0. Okay. Next, see, find the minor of the element, this 2. Then see, minor of 2 is equal to, this 2 is in third row. So, delete third row and third column. You will get one determinant 1, 2, 1, 1. Then it's equal to 1 into 1 is 1 minus 2 into 1 is equal to 2. It's equal to 1 minus 2. Its value equal to minus 1. This is the minor of the element 2. What's the last element in the given determinant? Okay, clear? Minor of any element is obtained by deleting the corresponding row and column of the determinant where that element belongs. Okay, next is cofactor. Cofactor of Aij is equal to minus 1 to the power I plus j into minor of Aij. Okay, minor of Aij. Okay, it's a formula. Cofactor of any element Aij is equal to minus 1 to the power I plus j into minor of Aij. Okay. That means you need to put the alternative plus minus sign according to the position of the element. Okay. You already studied how to calculate the minor of the element. For example, see, here I am writing one square matrix A equal to 1, 2, 0, 1. Now see, minor of 1 is equal to, this element 1 is equal to, how to get a minor? Delete the first row and the first column. Then you will get here 1. Okay. Then cofactor is equal to, what's a cofactor 1? Minus 1 to the power I plus j. I means which row, j means which column. 1 is in first row and first column. So I value is 1, j value is 1. 1 plus 1, minus 1 to the power 1 plus 1 into minor. What is minor? Into 1. It's equal to minus 1 to the power 2. It's equal to plus 1 into 1. Its value equal to 1. Therefore, cofactor equal to 1. Then see, minor of 2 is equal to, what's a minor of 2? That is obtained by deleting the first row and the second column. So here you'll get 0. Minor of 2 is equal to 0. Then what is cofactor? Cofactor is equal to minus 1 to the power I plus j. What is I value? This is in first row. I value is 1. Plus j. Which column? Second column. 1 plus 2. Okay. Into minor. What is a minor value? 0. It's equal to minus 1 to the power 1 plus 2. Minus 1 to the power 3. Minus 1 to the power odd number means minus 1 into 0, it's equal to minus 1 into 0, it's equal to 0. Okay. Consider this element 0. Minor of 0 is equal to, how to calculate minor of 0? Delete the second row and the first column. Then second row and the first column. Then 2 is remaining. Minor of 0 is equal to 2. then cofactor of 0 is equal to minus 1 to the power I plus j. Which row? I means row. Which row? Second row. Plus which column? First column. 1 into, what's a minor? Into minor is equal to 2. We know that minus 1 to the power 3 is minus 1 into 2 is equal to minus 2. Therefore, minor of 0 is equal to 2, but cofactor of 0 is minus 2. In the next step, see, one more element is remaining. Minor of 1 is equal to, what's a minor of 1? Delete the second row and the second column, will get 1. Minor of 1 is equal to 1. Then cofactor is equal to, how to calculate cofactor? Minus 1 to the power I plus j. 1 is in which row? Second row. Plus which column? Second column. Minus 1 to the power 2 plus 2 into, what's a minor of 1? Into 1. Minus 1 to the power 4 is plus 1. 1 into 1 is equal to 1. Okay? This is how to calculate cofactor when a determinant of order 2 is given. Okay? Similarly, you can calculate the cofactor of the determinant of order 3. First, calculate the minor. Then, use the note. Suppose, determinant of order 2 given. Determinant of order 2. 2 is given, then to calculate the cofactor, first calculate the minor, then use alternative plus minus
minus plus.
Then determinant of order 3 is given. Order 3 is given. First calculate the minor. Then according to the position, for plus plus into minor, then minus into minor, then plus into minor, then minus into minor, plus into minor, minus into minor, then plus into minor, minus into minor, plus into minor. To calculate cofactor, to the minor values, just multiply plus minus plus minus plus minus plus minus plus alternative plus minus. Starting with the plus, plus, minus, plus, then not plus, minus. It continues, okay? Plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, okay? Starting with the plus, end with the plus, okay? Multiply this alternative sign to the given minor values. Then you will get the cofactor of the given square matrix, clear? For example, see, A is equal to 2, 3, 4, minus 2, minus 1. And minus 3, minus 2, and 0. Okay? You need to calculate the cofactors of each entries. First, consider the determinant. Determinant A is equal to determinant of 1, 2, 3, 4, minus 2, minus 1, minus 3, minus 2, 0. Okay? Next, first calculate cofactor of 1. See, cofactor of 1 is equal to, use the previous note, it is plus minus plus minus plus minus and plus minus plus. First entry plus, right? So cofactor 1 is plus, then calculate the minor of the 1. What is minor of 1? How to calculate minor of 1? Delete this first row and the first column. Then you will get one determinant of order 2, right? Calculate the determinant value. Minus 2 into 0 is 0. Minus, minus 2 into minus 1 plus 2. So, plus 2. Then 0 minus 2, it's equal to minus 2. Because plus into minus equal to minus 2 is there. Then see, cofactor of the next element 2. In the second element, see, minus right here. So, put minus outside, minus of, delete the first row and the second column, right? This column we need to delete. Then what you will get? Determinant C, 4 minus 1 minus 3, 0, right? So calculate, 4 into 0 is 0, minus, this minus by formula, minus 3 into minus 1 is equal to plus 3. Okay, now see, 0 minus 3 is minus 3, but 1 minus n is outside, right? Minus into minus, its value equal to plus 3. Then see, cofactor of next element is 3 is equal to, how to calculate that one? Next sign see, plus, right? Plus, lead the first row and the third column. Then see what you will get. Determinant 4 minus 2 minus 3 minus 2. 4 into minus 2 equal to minus 8. Minus, this minus by formula. Then see, minus 3 into minus 2, it's equal to plus 6. It's equal to minus 8 minus 6. It's equal to minus 14. But plus sign outside, right? Plus into minus is equal to minus 14. Therefore, cofactor of 3 is equal to minus 14. Then next is cofactor of the element 4 is equal to, see, second row first entry, plus or minus? Minus, right? So minus into, you need to calculate minor of 4, right? So delete the second row and the first column. What you will get? Determinant 2, 3, minus 2, 0, right? 2 into 0 is 0, minus 2 into 3, it's equal to minus 6. Then see, 0 minus into minus plus 6, but already 1 minus in outside, therefore its answer equal to minus 6. Next see, cofactor of minus 2. Okay, then see, plus, right? Outside plus. Okay, then which, what's the position of minus 2? Second row and the second column. So you need to delete the second row and the second column. What you will get if you delete second row and second column? Determinant 1, 3, minus 3, 0, right? 1 into 0 is 0, minus, this is by formula, then minus 3 into minus 3, it's equal to minus 9. Then see, minus into minus plus 9, outside plus is there, plus into plus is equal to plus 9. Okay, the next step, you need to calculate the cofactor of minus 1. Here I'll write, cofactor of minus 1 is equal to, see, next minus, alternative plus minus, here minus into. Then see, what's the position of minus 1? Second row and the third column. You need to delete the third column. Then you will get determinant 1, 2, minus 3, 2, right? So 1 into minus 2 is equal to minus 2, minus, this minus by the formula, then minus 3 into 2, it's equal to minus 6. Okay, calculate the value. Minus 2 minus into minus plus 6, it's value equal to 4. Minus 1 into plus 4, it's equal to minus 4. Therefore, cofactor of minus 1 is minus 4. Next, cofactor of minus 3. Minus 3 is equal to, observe, minus 3. What is the position of minus 3? Minus 3 is in third row, right? R3 and column 1, right? How to calculate the minor? We already studied how to calculate minor. Delete the corresponding row and column. If you delete the third row and the first column, you will get, see, determinant 2, 3, minus 2, minus 1, right? See, outside plus sign. Now see, 2 into minus 1 is minus 2. Then minus 2 into minus 3 it's equal to minus 6. This minus by the formula. Simplify. Again see, minus 2 plus 6, it's equal to plus 4 into plus, it's equal to plus 4. Okay. Next, cofactor of next element is minus 2. What is the position of minus 2? The third row and the second column. Okay. Then you will get a determinant 1, 3, 4, minus 1. But see here, outside minus. Right? Alternative plus minus, in this position minus. Minus, then calculate the determinant. See, he will get a determinant only 1, 3, 4, minus 1. Right? 1 into minus 1 is minus 1. Minus 4 into 3 is equal to 12. Okay? Minus 12, minus 1, minus 13. Minus outside is equal to plus 13. Then last element C, cofactor of 0. Cofactor of 0 is equal to, see what's the cofactor of 0? See the position. Position of 0 is the third row and the third column. Delete third row and third column. You'll get a determinant 1, 2, 4, minus 2. Okay, but see outside plus sign. By this formula, outside plus sign, then calculate the minor. Okay, 1 into minus 2 is minus 2 minus by formula 4 into 2 is equal to 8. Minus 10 into plus, it's equal to minus 10. Okay, these are all cofactors of the elements. Now see, in the next step, I am collecting all these cofactors according to the position. What is cofactor of the element 1? It's equal to minus 2. What's the cofactor of 2? Cofactor of 2 is equal to 3. Cofactor of 3 is equal to minus 14. Cofactor of 4 is equal to minus 6. Cofactor of minus 2. Cofactor of minus 2 is equal to 9. And cofactor of minus 1 is equal to minus 4. Then see, cofactor of minus 3. It's equal to plus 4. Cofactor of minus 2 here 13. And cofactor of last entry 0, it's equal to minus 10. Okay. Now see, each element of the given square matrix A is replaced by its cofactors, right? Minus 2 is cofactor of 1. 3 is the cofactor of 2, or minus 10 is the cofactor of 0. Actually, one square matrix is given. Now, I am replacing each element of the given square matrix A by the cofactors and taking transpose. Okay. Then, this is called adjoint of the given square matrix A. Okay. Denoted by edge A. Okay. Clear? Adjoint of the given square matrix. If one square matrix is given, if each element of that square matrix is replaced by cofactors and taking transpose, we called it as adjoint of the given square matrix. Clear? In general, say I am taking one square matrix with A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A31, A32, A33. Generally, cofactors are denoted by caps letter AIJ. Cofactor of any element AIJ is denoted by caps letter AIJ. This is just notation. Okay. Now see, I am finding minor of all the elements, then calculating cofactors. Next step, I am replacing all the elements of the given square matrix by its cofactors. That means, here, right, A11, right, any element, cofactor of any element Aij is denoted by caps letter Aij, right. So, A11, A12, A13, and A21, A22, and A23, A31, A32, A33. Okay, all these are cofactors of the corresponding elements. After finding cofactors, if you take this transpose, okay, transpose of the cofactors, okay, then it's called adjoint of the given square matrix, okay, denoted by edge A. Okay, therefore adjoint of any square matrix A is obtained by replacing each element of the matrix A by the cofactors and taking transpose. Okay, what's the transpose? It's equal to A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, and next A31, A32, and A33. Clear? How to calculate the adjoint? Okay. First, you need to replace each entries by its cofactors. If you are not taking transpose, means it is not the adjoint of the given matrix. First, collect the cofactors according to the positions, then take the transpose. If you take the transpose, then we called it as adjoint of the given square matrix A. Clear? See, next some notes. First note is A into adjoint A is equal to adjoint A into A is equal to determinant of A into I. Okay, what is I? I is the identity matrix, right? Okay, remember, very important formula. They may ask, verify this one. A into edge A is equal to edge A into A equal to determinant A into I. Okay, note, see, determinant of edge A is equal to determinant A to the power n minus 1, where A is a square matrix of order n. It's a very important formula. If A is a square matrix of order n, then determinant of edge A is equal to determinant A to the power n minus 1. Okay. By this formula, you can say that again A is a square matrix of order n, then determinant of edge A into determinant of A. What is determinant of edge A? Determinant A to the power n minus 1 into determinant A. Here you will get determinant A to the power n. It's the next formula. Edge A, determinant of edge A into determinant of A is equal to determinant A to the power n. Next, see, fourth one, if determinant of A is equal to 0, then A is called a singular matrix. Okay, singular matrix. And if determinant A is not equal to 0, then A is called a non-singular matrix. Okay, remember these two formulas. Determinant A equal to 0 means singular matrix. Determinant A is not equal to 0 means non-singular matrix. In the next session, I will solve problems related to cofactors and adjoint of the square matrices. Thank you.